Hi guys, it's vlog time. Well, I haven't really done much today. The one thing I have done is made sure that is all assembled and took the power supplies out and stood it up on end. To get it to stand on end, I did have to take a couple of bits off, like this front piece. Just got that cover to stick back in. That's about it. I did have to take that front panel off to get it to sit nice and level. I didn't want it to rock around or damage anything. Pardon me. I've just been talking about this with someone on my Facebook, actually. I did Google it. I Googled the base number. It's written on the sticker. And it came back as a HP 9000 N4000 series. So it's an N series. And when I looked at the specs of the specific N model that it came up with, it matched this one. So there we go. That riddle is solved. I know what it is now. And if I forget, I've still got the number on the side. I can Google again. Still not sure what I'm going to do with it. I mean, it doesn't power on or anything. Well, it's not going to power on now because I've took the switch panel off. So, it's sitting there as a nice sort of computery tech ornament. If I laid it on its side in there, I've got a novelty coffee table. Actually, if I laid it on its front, that would work better as a coffee table because this back panel's just a plain sheet of metal, there's nothing on it. So if anything, I've got a novelty coffee table there. I haven't really done much. I want to get this hard drive caddy set up. Me and my friend last night did have a play with it. It does work. Those hard drives are dead. I know they're dead because I tried those two over there and this hard drive caddy worked fine. So those ones are dead. This top one here is actually out of my Compact Mini 110. That's the old one out of that. So yeah, confirmed deceased hard drive. I have got a desktop SATA hard drive lurking somewhere. I just can't find it. I don't think I put it in any PC. I don't think. Ooh. That might be in the Dell. That's, up there. It might be in that Dell. Or it might be in that one. I know. I just can't remember what I did with it. I know I've got one. So I know I can chuck it in there and have an external hard drive. But I don't know where I've put it. Never mind, I'll have a look for it later. I want to see what size hard drive I've put in my brother's as well. Because depending on its size, I might nick it back and put into my desktop for some more storage. And like I said, I've got other hard drives kicking about, or I'll just buy them a new one off eBay. Anyway, me and my buddy last night did try out this. I think I did a late night vlog, didn't I? Pardon me. But it seemed like this was getting far too hot. It wasn't overheating, but it was running a little hotter than we'd have liked. But when we had it running, we didn't have no side panels on this. And we didn't have no fans connected. I didn't have the front and rear fans connected because I pulled all those wires off just to make a bit of room to get that in because that's quite a large card. So what I'm going to do later, or actually I'll do it a bit later in this video, I'm going to put the card back in and then I'm going to connect up the front and rear fans, etc., etc. and let it run, and then do another temperature check with CPU ID, and see if it runs any cooler. Obviously, I'll put both side panels back on as well. So that will be the plan. Yeah, I suck at cable management in computers. Right, so I've just got to pop to the bathroom, and I'll be well. Here we go. Just move that stuff out of the way. Loose baked bean on the worktop. Get out of it. There we go. Quick wipe. There we go. We've got some clean space now. Right. So the first job to do is to put this video card in the machine. I'm sure most of us know how to do that by now. Oh, getting cables caught up. Right. Go in there. Now. Just to make sure the card sits in there nice and stable, I'm going to put the screw in. Right. Oh, good. It does clear the USB headers. It does clear the audio header as well, but I'm going to just have to have a bit of a sort out. Oh, do I have some screws somewhere? What cuddle? Just get the hard drive put back in. Just make life a bit easier while working on the system. I'm going to plug everything else back in while I'm at it. That's got to go in the back of the video card. I'll put that out of the way for a minute. Stand up there, and that's for that. Ah. Use a different connector, that would help. Actually help a great deal, but I can't remember which way up they go now. Now that I've pulled one off. Oops. Nope. Other way up then. Ah, there we go. Bit slack on that one now. Right, now what I want to do to make life easier is reach around the back here, pull the audio cable through, and go over the top, and I'm going to go underneath all the power cables. See, I do a bit of cable management, just not a lot. Right. Do it left-handed, I think. It's a good job I'm pretty ambidextrous when it comes to things like this. Right, that's that one in. I'm not actually 100% certain if this is going to reach the fan header. Ooh, that is actually going to be quite tight. I may actually have to go and find an adapter cable for that. It's another side. I've got two Molexes in use there. Oh, sorry. I've got a spare Molex connector up the top here that'll do for the front fan. That will plug in. Unplugged, so it's got to go back bloody in. There we go. Oh, that ain't good. Just push the bloody cable out the Molex connector. Oh, I see. That's a spare SATA. SATA adapter, so. Okay. Either way, I've got plonked on here, haven't I? Hopefully. Open these up a little bit. I think they've got squished. Try that. Get in there, bitch. Hey, charge in. There we go. Still connected in that time. Right, I can go down there at the Y. Let's get video card power plugged in. Might as well. That's another one. Can't believe it's got to take two of these. Two of the damn connectors. Right. Cat, I'd love to keep the cable up there out of the bloody way. There we go. That's a USB connector. So is that. Did I put a card? That's one. One's for the card reader, one's for USB ports. Right, so, pull one through. Put one on. One more, which is the black one, which is for the card reader. And apart from the rear fan, this is all ready to be connected in. I don't like how tight this is pulling over here, but I do have an adapter that I should be able to use if I can find it. In that box. I might actually take the adapters out of there and just sit in there for a minute. Because adapters are useful, but not when they're in here. I've got another Molex one. So it just means I have to keep tipping this box out every time I watch SATA cable or a adapter of some description. Chuck some of them over there. That's a weird one. And the last four. And over there. Molex splitter. What else have we got? Another SATA cable. This one will be bad. I'll sort the rest of the cables out later, but this is what I wanted. It's basically a Molex. I see. What we do. I think this will work. looks like I've got to plug that end into the actual fan plug on the motherboard. Get my hand under there to get it on. So I've got SATA cables in the way, and then I've got the video card in the way. See if I can sort of guide it on using the wires itself. Not easy at all. I'm starting to think I should have put this on before I put the video card in. But I didn't think of using one of these, I didn't think I'd need it. But there isn't any, any other fan headers. There we go, that's on. And then the fan, we connect into there. I don't suppose I'd have to plug that in. I suppose it's only if you want to use the speed feature. I just want it to work. Right. Ooh. Let's tuck these cables in out of the way. Otherwise, I won't get the side cover on. Wrong side cover. Goes on there, so where have I put the other one? There it is. Sort of doing this sort of blind. Not quite got it. I won't go into, but I will. Just for the simple fact these panels are going to move. I know they are. So I'm going to put one screw in for the time being. Temporarily, so I can put this epoxy panel on. There we go. Whack a screw. Well, actually, I don't think I need to take this side off anymore. So I'm going to put both screws back in this side. For a moment, I grabbed two power cables that I borrowed last night to power the paperweight. So now I need two cables back. There we go. I've actually sent an eBay seller a request to close a case against me now that the item has arrived. It arrived to him yesterday. I got the message, so he can't pull a fast one and say items didn't arrive. Yeah, they did. You sent me a message saying they did through eBay, so there won't be any denying it. So the case will be closed. Throw the interweb cable in as well, and when I can find it, or get hold of it rather, DVI, like so, power, took a while for it to power up. The rear fan isn't working. I'm not sure about the front one. Right, in that case, side panel has to come off. And it looks like I've got to connect the Molex. Obviously, I'm not doing it live, I'm just taking the cover off. Yeah, front fan's working. As long as I don't nudge the cable. Rear one isn't. I've got some bloody Molex to connect that to. Well, watch power supply I've got on this one. Oh, 550 watt. Oh, that's more than enough. More than enough. There you go. Sit and study the pretty blue fan. I'll sign into this and shut down so I can. So I can get this back fan working. I don't think I've got one with a longer. See, that's not too warm at the minute. So maybe with some better air circulation in here. There's not going to be any audio either, because I've got no audio connected. My monitor doesn't support audio. I've heard that Windows 10 is being released in July. Which will be awesome, because I do want to upgrade. I want to take advantage of the free upgrade for Windows 7 users. I'll miss Windows 7 if I do like to use it. I've got some shit in my rollerball mouse because it's not working properly. right. I'm going to turn off. Wall to turn off. Right, just put another screw in here to keep that stable as well. So, plug those together and that in to there. Clump of wires together. Right, I'm going to stuff those clump of wires up there because I want the airflow to be as free as possible. Yep. Ooh, I've got a better idea. Better idea instead of put three together. Take that one off. Take that middle bit out. Put those together. Tuck those down there. You can put the fan on the same Molex connector as the other one. Whee! You have another fan working. Good. Goes on. There we go. cover, put the screw back in, put the password in. Very clackety keyboard. I do like a clackety keyboard. So, it's pumping up enough air out the back, and the front one is sucking in, so we should weave some cooler air in there. That should, that cooler. Just let this all finish brewing up, and then I'll bring up the CPU ID. And we can see what current temperatures are. CPU's okay. It's creeping up slowly. Although it is sitting at 48 degrees. Which is a lot cooler than it was last night with those fans now going. Went up a degree, it's 49 now. I could try a fan on the side case as well. I've got plenty of fans to use. But it's definitely running several degrees cooler now with those fans on. My processor temperature is actually running pretty cool. Core 0 is 33 degrees and Core 1 is 28 degrees. Well, that isn't too bad. Not too bad. Gone up to 50 degrees now, that ATI Radeon. So the longer I leave it, the hotter it seems to be getting. A lovely breeze coming off the back of that. Right. What I'm going to do then, I'm going to leave it idling with that up. I'm going to go back to the main PC and leave it for a while and see if it does get any hotter. I can actually feel a lot of heat coming off this bit. Yeah, so that's what I'm going to do. So, I'll be back. Well, this has been sitting here idling for about half an hour, 45 minutes, and that temperature hasn't changed. And I even watched a YouTube video, and that didn't change. I'm sort of stuck on what else to put it through. Pardon me. Yep. Now it's playing a video and it still hasn't gone up. bounced up another degree. Oh no. Whether to try a fan on the side panel here or not. See if that'll help. It's not like I don't have enough fans. I don't know. Let's have a sort through the cables before I do anything else. Believe me if I said I actually, not that long ago, sorted all these IDE cables out and got rid of a load. Now look at them. I've got a load back. Another one. Another one. Adapter cable. I'm going to go in there. Got a cable for stepdad. Not about those ones yet. I'll just concentrate on these IDE cables for now. Slot cable over there. Quite extra long, what looks like a fan cable. Heat sink, that don't go in here, I don't know why that's in here. That might be handy as well. There's another Morelex adapter with a fan cable on it. That'll do nicely. There's another one. May need another one, that's why the other reason I was just going through these cables. I will have to have another go through all these bloody IDE cables again, because I don't need all these. Yep, they're still coming. Another one. We are getting there, though. Yep, getting there. My long SATA cable for the power edge. Another short SATA. Experimenting purposes. Right, well, that was the last ribbon cable. Yeah, IDE cable. Ribbon cable. Now, up here I've got loads of other adapter cables and whatnot. These aren't actually adapter cables, these are various front panel cables and whatnot. I don't even know why I bothered keeping these, to be honest. It's not like you really use them. Another ribbon cable, I lied. IDE cable! Fucking ribbon cable. It's a Dell switch. It's another Dell switch. There's a bit of wind. Behind me. Yeah. I really do not need all those IDE cables. Behind me I've got these. Have a quick quick look to see what I've got. I've got a couple of these. I cut off a power pack that I could butcher in if I wanted to, or whatever. It's one of these 4-pin 12 volt connectors. It's a splitter. So we've got two of them. What else have we got? It's a Molex splitter. I think that's another Molex splitter. It is in a... Yeah, it's a Molex to 2 SAR. See? SAR cable. SAR cable. Molex to SAR. Molex and fan, or with a fan adapter. Not sure what you'd use this one for. Unless it lets you connect the fan to the motherboard, or I don't know. What's this one? That's a Molex splitter with another floppy drive connector on it, from the look of it. That's the one I want for the extra fan. I'm going to try. There's a few other various fan adapters on here, and SATA, my extra long SATA that's got to go in the power edge. So that's pretty much all the sort of adapter cables I've got. Not a lot. Well, adapter and SATA cables, I should say. Not a lot at all. I can't see it anymore, over here anymore. Right, so I want that, I want another 5-inch fan. Which is going to be in my fan box. Like that. That don't belong in there. Come on, look at that. Here's what I found earlier. Whoops! Dropped the whole lot. Well, I suppose it doesn't have to be a 5-inch, does it? It could be smaller. Right, I've got to find this fan and get this installed and give it another try, so... Be back. Well... I have a side fan on. But... still not made a blind bit of difference, so... Maybe it's just its operating temperature, I don't know. But it doesn't seem to increase or decrease or do anything. And that extra fan hasn't made a blind bit of difference, so I'm gonna, when I shut down, I'll take that off. And I'll probably take that video card out. I've got an anti-static bag somewhere, I'll stick that one. So, let's shut down. Then, I was thinking of having a play with that one behind there. Doing what? I don't know yet. Get my ugly mug. Get this fan out of here. Oh, no wonder. There's a connection here, so every time I nudge the cable, the fans would cut off. What was I doing? Oh yeah, I was going to take the video card out of this, wasn't I, as well. Get the fan off the side here out of the way first. Preferably without dropping the side panel on the floor. I think I might just be out of camera view. Right. Put the side panel down that way. Lid so. can chuck that somewhere out the way. Well, not chuck it, but put it out the way somewhere. Right. We can unplug. Ouch. That. And, how the hell did that get through there? Ooh. That was magic. Come out there. Unplug the connectors. Don't need that. I'm not going to need this in here either, am I? Unplug that. I do need the fan plugged back in there, so there we go. They can go in there, like that. Unplug that. Actually, as I'm putting this PC together, I can unplug everything. Now, look at that. Now, get rid of that tea towel for a minute. Poo. I dropped my screw. Safe to put it apart from up there until I go and get the anti-static bag. Extra Molex collector. Connector there that I didn't realise was in here. That's got to go on the motherboard. Ooh, this hard drive's a bit warm. Ooh. Right. There we go. Put the side cover back on now. I'm just going to make sure everything is connected as it should. Just gonna adjust some cable management here. Got another cable laying down here I don't need at the minute. So tuck it down the back there out the way. Allow for a little bit better airflow, I hope. Well, that's the idea, anyway. Right. On with the side cover. I don't know about anyone else, but when I'm doing side covers, I always find them easier to go on if the machine's laying on its side. Right. One. And two. Now, I tested a fan I'd had kicking around in that box from the last computer haul. It doesn't work. It's only that clear one in there, that's why it's in the bin. I did take that off, because I could wire that to a fan and have a nice little Molex adapter on it. Right, so I'll tuck that PC back under here now. Just remembered there's a screw rattling around in the bottom of the case. Oh well. If I ever want a screw, I know where there is one. Right. Not sure what to do with this machine. Shall we see if we can find out exactly what the video card is? I think I may actually have one very, very similar to this. Yeah, I think I have, but a slightly different model. It's got Elixir memory on it. I don't know if that can be read on the camera, but it is Elixir. There's an ordering code. GeForce FX. Damn my eyesight. Hang on. GeForce FX 5200 128 megabytes DDR TV DVI. Oh yeah, it's got a DVI socket on it. There we go. I thought that was an NVIDIA. Probably wasn't a bad card back in its day. NVIDIA certainly was popular. Personally, I still like NVIDIA. Put the video card back in because there's no onboard video on this motherboard. It's pretty limited. Titties. I have to re-magnetise my screwdriver. I could get the board number and, I don't know, try and restore it as a Asus computer. I don't think I've actually got any Asus computers. But I would have to take the zip drive out because someone's cable management's better than mine. It's all zip tied up. It's probably been like that since it was built in the factory. Right, so it's a zip drive that has a Molex connector and hard drive IDE Cabal. All I'd have to do is take that out and install a hard drive, and for the sheer numptiness of it, I can clean the cobwebs out. That might be a start. All I can see on this is it's an Asus P4V800-X. So, if I could find the drivers for this, perhaps the utility, yeah, I could probably restore it. But I don't have a thing for the zip drive, so the zip drive is not really useful. Not unless I set it. Well, it looks like it's got jumper settings on it, so I could set it as a slave drive, I suppose, and put it on with the hard drive. That's one option. Options. Right. Well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to end this video and put the footage onto the PC and start a fresh one playing with that one. Turn that light off for a minute. Come in here and I will say thank you for watching, and until the next video, I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.